talk a lot about Engineer Without Borders because George talked a lot. It has all Engineer Without Borders in all the region have the same visions and missions. But we are focused on non-profit organization. Our organization established in 2006, especially in Bethlehem City. We have 150 members between professionals and students in different universities. Our chapters are six, between five in West Bank and one in Gaza City. And this is our website. I don't know if you, all of you know the Palestine maps or something about Palestine. We have two main regions separated to each other. This is, this is our map. Palestine nowadays, the Palestinians live in two separate regions. This is Gaza Strip, which have we have one chapter in it. And West Bank, in several places in the north, we have two universities. In the middle, one university, and in the south, one university. And our main our main board in Bethlehem City. We our vision is about developing country and talking about implementing sustainable engineers project. Without any relation to political issues or any profit or any, all of us work as a volunteer work. That make us a partner with the Palestinian disadvantaged communities to improve people's life, and it's not related to the benefit of our society, just to people live in rural area, but it's also to develop the people who try to do something for their countries. We focus on environmental and economical sustainable engineering projects for the rural areas especially. The main themes of our organization is how EWB Palestine work and how we can work together and our projects. We put as an engineer our themes and we put needs and issues according to engineers' side and opinions. We put we have special political issues in our region in Palestine, so our issues focus on sustainable political situation, high energy and resources. And so we need a peace, we need to reuse these resources and to do some projects that can help our resources. It's a little resources, but we can do something for it. These needs could be the need for many development countries, especially in Palestine. What our preparation or corporation project was within EW International, and local organization and international organization, and EWB Denmark was one of our partner or in some project in Palestine that Ahmed will talk about it later. Our small projects that we started was in 2007 until 2010. It was about a training course for students, for graduated students, because these courses that help them in work through organization in softwares that are exist. Each company have a conditions and limitation for work there. So we try to do something for this graduated engineer to help them in the work. Other project was solar energy training course. We focus now on solar energy project, and Ahmed will talk about that, this later. But so because of that, we did two courses in 2008 and 2010. So we give a course, a training course, how to use the solar energy without the need of a grid. That was incorporation of with the International Solar Energy Center in Colorado and Colorado University. Also, we try to do a small project with the UNRWA to prepare a lab, a laboratory, how to check and make a test for their solar panels and solar panels in their laboratory. One of the other type of our project was OpenStreetMap with Jumpstart International. That was the first project not related to solar. That was in Bethlehem city in 2008. How to do a street map by using GPS. At that time, we didn't have a GPS or network or something like that. We tried to start this project, and after that, other organizations tried to complete the project in several areas in Palestine, in other cities. One of our also project is Ariel House. That was a house worked with the solar panels and biogas and solar cooker. It was a simple house. To maybe we use it as an educational project for future students. The final activity, you know, all of you maybe know about Gaza war, so we try to help them in such a way as a volunteer work. Provide them or support them by 22 tanks of water, each tank between 1.5 cubic meter. This tank, we maybe most of people or organization try to give Gaza a little bottle of water, but we think about the future that maybe we can use this tanks in other projects. Until the situation will be in peace. The final activity now, we try to do something with EWU France to make a climate project carbon footprint. This is as a project with the engineers that still want to graduate in our universities, so we hope it will finish soon. And also, one of the most activities that we maybe we are proud of it was a car working by water. We got on a 12 level and with the Middle East Environment Leadership Program, and that was from student still graduated until now. Now Ahmed will talk about our project.
Good afternoon. My voice maybe is not good. Also a member in EWB Palestine, working with Hebron University as a renewable energy coordinator, and volunteer with EWB Palestine, board member. experience started in solar energy in 2008. This is because EWB Palestine make the first training in solar energy. So I attend the training and start my experience there, and then joined the Hebron University and start a small activities. But actually now we are going to do apply a new strategy called the Green Campus Activity. We will try to use solar energy to minimize the loads inside the, of the energy consumption inside the university. So this is most of the activities we done there. From the small, and then now we will have a 220 kilowatt peak solar energy plant. So it will give us around 1 megawatt every day total. Also, that was inside the university. Outside the university, we start working with the rural communities in Beit Lahem and Hebron. We did around 14 kilowatt peak of grid solar system. I will not talk about Hebron University a lot, so I will try to. Empty slide. Okay. During our visit here in Denmark, one of the companies asked us to fill application. So I start filling the application, and then they said, "Please fill your country name." I tried to Palestine. There is no Palestine. Occupied Palestinian territory. Also nothing. And then West Bank. Oh. Nothing. So this generates a question. What is Palestine? So I try to find an internet and find maybe this a good answer for my question. So 2 minutes of video, maybe.
Ms. Keller, I have a question. Why is only so the Palestinians live here, but they don't have a country of their own.
Why not?
It's complicated, but let me try to explain. One country in a place they call a human. After World War II, Western powers divided it between them, but Arab nations said no. Over the years, wars were fought with the new country of Israel, and Israel alone, taking control of Palestinian land. There hasn't been peace since. Now 1.5 million Palestinians live in Gaza, packed into this tiny strip of land. And more are refugees in other countries or live here, in East Jerusalem and the West Bank. But Israeli governments have covered this Palestinian land with new Jewish towns called settlements. Settlers are just 1/10 of the population, but they've taken over most of the land. The settlements are like colonies, built to control as much land and water as possible. They're illegal under international law, but no one stops them. Some settlements have a lot of guns, but this is not the Wild West. They have malls, factories, swimming pools. They get 3 times as much water as Palestinian villages, which have to deal with shortages and settlement sewage. The settlements are connected by a maze of roads, some only Israelis can use. While Palestinians can spend hours every day passing through military checkpoints just to get to school or work or even the hospital. Some Palestinians have never been able to visit relatives who live just miles away. Israel has also built a huge security wall that's taken over even more land. It cut some Palestinian villages down the middle, separating farmers from their lands and people from their friends and family. So the real map looks like this, with the wall, roads, and over 200 settlements squeezing Palestinians into small pockets. You see, Lisa, today there still really isn't a place that Palestinians can call their own.
Thank you. myself on my question today. Okay, we are not political people, but maybe we should talk a little bit about the political issues, because we believe that the renewable energy maybe it's the solution for our political. Our work, especially all the time in the area C, which is the white card here. According to us, also agreement, we have area A, which is controlled by the Palestinian National Authority. Area B, which is mixed between civil control for the Palestinian and security for the Israeli. This color, maybe you can match between the colors. And area C, which is our target of working, because no one can make infrastructure there. So we would not have electricity, have a lot of suffering there. And these are the settlements here that you see. So we talk a lot about rural areas. What is the rural areas in Palestine? Rural areas is located most of the time beside the settlements and surrounded by the settlements. Sometimes it's more than 4 or 5 settlements surrounding the areas. And most of the work there is agriculture, work, and sheep grazing. They live actually inside tents, caves, barracks. Until now, you maybe imagine people live in caves. There are people still live in caves. And they use the animals, the transportation between the communities, because there is no roads, only tracks there. There is a lot of risk. If somebody want to make infrastructure or to start building some home, there is a risk for demolition or immigration. There is a demolition, immigration, or maybe from the environment, diseases or some of the insects, snakes. Yeah. Actually, their children also need some, they have some needs as any children in the world. They need medicine, they need food, they want everything here. So you can find here this child holds this bottle of medicine, and the other child here is waiting him to finish it to make his toy. They are creative.
An engineer.
Yeah. So they need a lot. We focus mostly in awareness and energy, but other, they need medicine, schools, hygiene, roads there, they want everything. But we focus as EWB Palestine mostly in awareness and electricity, because in the meantime we have some coordination with NGOs that support this type of activities. If we are lucky, we can find other people, we can work with them for other projects. This is the project we have. These are the projects we are working with EWB Denmark. We actually implement 3 projects, joint projects. All of the aim there is to improve the people living in this area, improve the life standard there. And the first project was implemented in Hebron, in the south of Palestine. We implement a hybrid system that works in wind turbine and solar energy for 15 families. We will talk about the loads, but this is the first project, was in 2010. This is the second project, but I will talk about, the first project was a school project. It's Rawain in Bethlehem, this area called the Rawain community in Bethlehem. The school location here, they have around 60 students in the school. without electricity. So the, we did a project for them in cooperation with EWB Denmark for the small loads there. They have a copy machine, computer, and the ring telephone. They was using the old one with the hand shaking. This is the second project. The first project was 2011. The second project we did it last year in the in this area. So now we have three projects: two in Rouen and three, and the third one, or the first one we did it in Hebron. There is 20 families located somewhere here, and scattered 10 families and 20 families scattered in this area. But unfortunately, we cannot finish the community, and still five families living in this area without electricity. Fortunately, this year we got a fund from UNDP and finished the families. We assume that we finished, but actually, some people come back to the village again. Around 10 families come back. So now these are the 10 families that came back to the village again, and now we have to try search for a fund for them and give them the electricity. Some pictures of the first project is the school. We also supply the mosque here, because the mosque is community based, that most of the people came to the mosque and can charge their mobiles there. This type of loads, printer, television, and the ring here. It was around 800 watt peak. University of August, Yusuf, here, they attend the installation. The third project, and the second one in Rouen, was off-grid system for the 30 families. These are the families, and this is the installation cables. When we start, only 7 families attend. Now they are 10, and most of them attend, because we asked the first question, if you want to electricity, you should contribute. Because we believe if he didn't contribute, we will not use it as we need. So the system will die soon. And this is the second 20 families, and the first 15 families was attended, and now they are 20. EWB Palestine and EWB Denmark jointed in this project with their chapters. Our chapter in Najah University, and attend the installation. Also, EWB Denmark, August, and DTU attend the installation for 10 days. They came to Palestine and enjoyed working there. These are the whole picture you can see. This is the community, most of them tents and barracks. There are some places you can find caves. And the system, the 10 families, 2.5 kilowatt and 4.2 kilowatt. The 20 families. What do we think we did? We increased education, because we installed the school. We charged the cell phones, because we have now electricity in the homes and the mosque. We can assume that some of the medicine can be stored in the refrigerator, because they have one refrigerator in each base. People now know and aware about the surrounding news. They go to television and see what happened in between the areas. Also, now we have a new 10 families. Came back to the village. We are trying and hoping to increase the income, to make generating income for the villagers. Maybe this is the next step now, without thinking about it. These are the one of the families that came back, and another picture for a celebration here, a wedding party. They have now fans and washing machine. They can enjoy it. Women actually they enjoy it because they have television and washing machine. When we start thinking about joint project, we start thinking about making a survey study of the area, what they need, what loads they need to power on, and then we can propose activity and send it for fundraising. Maybe all the time we knock the door of EWB Denmark first, and then go to other parties. And if we get the fund, so we can start working. Management, preparing the community, if they want to contribute or no, awareness, how they can use the system, and training. We always select some people from the community to work as professionals there. They can take care about the system. And then a joint installation. Our chapters from here and there join the installation. This is a picture of the UNDP last 5 families. We actually finished it before I came here. And in other area, we also, from the same fund, we implement another system in Hebron. So I think Hanan can, So in the end, maybe we believe that our collaboration with EWB Denmark is useful and fruitful and can help for us to bring more credibility. EWB Palestine also looking forward for full cooperation with EWB Denmark, especially because we have experience and for other NGOs here, not for EWB as one organization. So we are happy to work together in any kind of projects